10-minute rule motion, Mr. Raymond Chishti.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I beg to move that leave be given to bring in a bill to allow the Magistrates' Court discretion to refer a third or subsequent offence for drink driving to the Crown Court for sentencing and to grant the Crown Court the jurisdiction to give a custodial sentence of up to 2 years. When a driver gets behind the wheel, they have responsibility for their own and other road users' safety. But public safety is put at risk by those who choose to drink and drive. Studies have consistently shown that someone's ability to drive is impaired by having alcohol present in their blood and that the risk increases as more alcohol is consumed. The risk to public safety has been recognised in law for almost 90 years, since the first drink driving offence was introduced in 1925. The current statutory provisions governing drink driving makes it an offence to drive or attempt to drive whilst under the influence of drug or with excess alcohol in one's bloodstream. Currently, the maximum sentence an offender can receive is 6 months in prison, which is the same for a first, for a second, for a third, for a fifth, sixth, or seventh offence. I believe this needs to change so that those who continue to re-offend face tougher sentences, and those who persist in driving after drinking over the legal limits will be deterred from doing so. There has been a huge shift in the public's attitudes towards drinking and driving over the years, and we should not lose sight of the significant achievements that have been made by successive governments to tackle this. In 1979, 28 people were killed or seriously injured every day in drinking and driving accidents. 30 years later, it has fallen to 4 a day, despite the volume of traffic increasing 80% since the 1980s. By combining education and enforcement through Think campaign run at Christmas and in the summer, road safety has improved. Yet more still needs to be done and has to be done. The figures show that in 2011, almost 10,000 casualties occurred when someone was driving whilst over the legal alcohol limit. Sadly, 1,570 people were killed or seriously injured in drink driving accidents in 2011, which is up on the previous year. More people are in fact killed as a result of drink driving than from knife crime. Yet the maximum penalty for knife crime and carrying a knife is 4 years imprisonment, compared to the significantly lower 6 months for drink driving. Worryingly, many drivers continue to ignore the risks and get behind the wheel after drinking, with 8% of drivers admitting that they have driven in the last 12 months, believing they were over the legal limit. And according to a recent AA popular survey, 1 in 5 motorists have admitted to risking drink and driving at Christmas, whilst nearly 20,000 extra breath tests were carried out by the police in December last year. More than 7,000 of those breathalyzed were found to be drink drivers. In Medway, which includes my own constituency, more than 30 arrests were made during the Christmas crackdown period. It is clear that the current law is not a powerful enough deterrent for many people, as 12% of offenders will go on to drink and drive again, some of whom have been disqualified and uninsured. The re-offending rate is even greater for high-risk offenders, which includes those who have previously been disqualified twice for drink driving offences, with 3 out of 10 of them repeating the offence. And I say to the minister who I see sitting at the front, the same proposals that I'm outlining today could also be applied to those who drive whilst disqualified, as driving whilst disqualified is linked to drink driving. Recently we had one case in Medway where a driver was caught in astonishingly 5 times in 11 years, but still he escaped a prison sentence. The latest review into drink driving laws in 2010 by Sir Peter North noted it is a minority of drivers who persist in drink driving. In the coalition government's response to the North review, it stated that many drivers, drink drivers, are well above the limit. A staggering 40% of those caught are 2.5 times over the lawful limit. To tackle this problem, or this behaviour, of this minority of hardcore drink drivers, that needs to be targeted. As the Secretary of State for Transport, at the time of the report, the Right Honourable Member for Runnymede and Weybridge told the House in a written statement, their behaviour is entrenched and displays a flagrant disregard for the law and the safety of other road users. The government's response indicated that the biggest deterrent is the perceived risk of the severe consequences of detection. And under the plans I'm outlining today, there will be a serious deterrent not to drink and drive. So how will this work in practice? On the first offence, the vast majority of drink drivers receive a non-custodial sentence, usually consisting of a fine and a driving ban. On a second offence, or in aggravating circumstances, we would expect the Magistrates Court to give a harsher sentence, ranging from a community penalty to a custodial sentence. On a third offence, the Magistrates Court would have a discretion to refer the case to the Crown Court, where the offender would receive up to 2 years imprisonment. This measure would provide the courts with the additional tools they need to tackle those who persist in flouting the law. The principle of increased sentences for repeat offenders proposed in this bill has already been applied to other crimes. The powers of the Criminal Courts Sentencing Act provides a minimum sentence of 3 years for a third offence for a burglary. It is also a system that has been adopted in other countries. In New Zealand, a motorist caught over limit for a third or a subsequent offence faces 2 years imprisonment. In the Australian state of New South Wales, you can also receive a 2 year sentence for subsequent offences. And in America, many states have imposed more than 1 year prison sanctions on those who re-offend three times or more. It is clear that to reduce drink driving casualties further, we need to take a tougher stance. And this proposal will send a clear message to those who continue to drink and drive that they will face up to 2 years in prison if they persist in exceeding the legal limits and continue to put innocent lives at risk. This bill will mean that we continue to have some of the toughest drink driving laws, but also some of the safest roads. And Madam Deputy Speaker, I commend this bill to the House.
The question is that the Honourable Member have leave to bring in the bill. As many of that opinion say aye.
Aye.
Of the contrary, no. The ayes have it. The ayes have it. Who will prepare and bring in the bill?
Keith Vaz, Kate Howie, Steve Baker, Laura Lee Burt, Gordon Henderson, Valerie Waz, Gareth Johnson, Angie Bray, David Ruffley, Henry Smith, John Stevenson, and myself, Madam Deputy Speaker.
Raymond Shishti.
Drink Driving Repeat Offenders Bill.
Second reading, what day?
22nd of November 2013.
22nd of November 2013.